Their chants are now familiar, heard at protests across the country. But this time, the chants are coming from Irving. Protesters march through downtown, spreading their messages and showing they are as committed to their cause as they are to keeping this march peaceful.
Keeping it peaceful, absolutely. Everybody's united because they want to see change.
What do you think just of this turnout that you're seeing today?
I think this is beautiful. This is exactly what the movement needs.
The group reached City Hall, where they stopped to hear from speakers.
And that's what this type of movement is. It's going against the wind. You're making a lot of people uncomfortable, and it needs to happen. But then sometimes you gotta sail with the wind.
Yeah.
Sometimes you gotta sail with those that are trying to help you in the movement.
I'm just hoping that from this, then we can begin to have some real substantive conversations that will affect some real change.
This can't be all about emotion. This can't be all about feel-good moments. It ain't gonna change unless you make it change.
Yeah.
There's gonna be a voter registration table. If you ain't registered, get registered.
Volunteers and supporters helped keep the crowd hydrated. And throughout the event, Irving police officers kept their eyes on everything. They report no arrests.
You know, we've seen these protests that have been occurring all over the United States. We wanted to make sure that in Irving specifically, these protesters and demonstrators were able to come out and have a safe event. We welcome everybody's right to their First Amendment and their freedom to assemble.
The protesters left City Hall and stopped on Irving Boulevard, where many kneeled for nearly 9 minutes.
To signify how long the officer had his knee on George Floyd's neck.
It is a visual and vocal demonstration that they hope will have an impact on the future, drawing on lessons from history.
I've been in LULAC for 40 years fighting for civil rights. And I thought my generation was going to be the one to solve it. So I'm kind of saddened that, as you can tell in my voice, I'm saddened that we didn't solve it. That I had to say to my son, I'm sorry. You know, I've got to pass this on to you. I've got to pass this on to your generation.
They are optimistic change will come through chanting, marching, and civic engagement happening across the country, including here in Irving. Thomas Gandy for City Source.